Hello, Northwest ISD. My name is Jeremy Raw, and I am the Creative Media Production Coordinator here in the district. And we are here live in the NHS TV studios to sit down with the Executive Director of Athletics, Coach Joel Johsson. Joel, it's great to have you here in the studio and to be able to come in and talk about Northwest ISD athletics here in the middle of this pandemic.
Ah, thanks for having me.
So the first question I have is, are we going to play football? Are we going to have football this year?
We're as of today, we're planning on having football. We're planning on having all of our sports. Calendars changed a little bit from the UIL, but we do have a plan in place to have all of our sports.
Okay, so basically we're going to go into remote here August 20th to September 11th. When we come back September 14th, what are middle school athletics going to look like?
Okay, middle school athletics is going to look a little bit different than high school, and we'll probably hit on those here in just a little while. But for our middle school kids, from August the 20th until September the 8th, all of their instruction is going to be remote in athletics as well. We've got a plan with our coaches to Zoom with our athletic kids. There may be exercises through that Zoom. There may be leadership pieces, culture pieces, character pieces through that Zoom, but from August the 20th until September the 8th, we'll be all virtual in athletics as well, just like we are with the other subjects.
And so in theory, when we come back to school September 14th, would they begin practice?
Yeah, and actually what we're gonna do, Jeremy, to align our middle school competitive district with who we're playing, which is the Keller ISD, Carroll ISD, and Coppell ISD, we're actually going to bring up our volleyball teams and our football teams beginning September the 8th. We're gonna do it in the evenings, probably have one group from 5 to 6, another group from 6 to 7, hoping that our parents can set aside plans for transportation. And we're gonna do our acclimation period for our football, kind of start the beginning phases of our volleyball tryouts so that on the 14th, we're ready to go just like the Kellers and the Carrolls and the Coppells. And it keeps us, like I said, on the same playing schedule with all the people we play.
Okay, so now that we've talked about middle school, what are high school athletics gonna look like? How's that going to be different?
High school's gonna be different. And the reason high school's gonna be a little bit different is because the UIL has some different rules for our high schools. So starting on the 20th, everybody in our high school programs is going to be on campus, whether they're in season, which is football, volleyball, cross country, team tennis, all in season, or even if they're out of season, baseball, softball, wrestling, soccer, all of those sports are going to come on campus beginning August the 20th. Now, what we've done to help with transportation and to help get those kids back in front of their computer so that they're ready for first period or they're not gonna have to leave sixth period on the B day early is we're gonna have two different sessions of practices. There's gonna be a group go from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Now they'll be back home in front of their computer at 10 o'clock. Or a group that's going to go from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m., which allows them to stay in remote learning all day, but then make it to us for off-season or in-season practices. And our coaches are going to communicate with our kids and with our parents which one of those groups they fall in, whether the 7 in the morning or the 5 in the afternoon.
So as we're working through this remote phase, how will communications take place? How will our athletes get their information from your department?
Coaches will be communicating mainly through email. They've got all their kids contact already that are signed up in athletics. Also be looking for their Twitter accounts. I think all of our programs have their own separate Twitter. And then I'll be sending information out through our NISD blast email that goes to all of our families. And if everything goes right, we'll include this link and click on this and also get the information.
All right, Joel, so typically our athletes have to have physicals before they begin playing in athletic play. How's that gonna work this year in the middle of remote learning?
It's gonna be different than what we've had in the years past. Usually we require that kids get an athletic physical every year. This year, because of COVID and because our kids were not involved in athletics since basically spring break, the UIL has changed that rule. So this year, every student athlete will have to complete their medical history portion of their paperwork. And there's questions 1 through 6 are deal with medical history. As long as we have a physical on file from the previous year, or you bring that physical with you if you're a new student to NISD and you don't check yes to any of the medical history questions, you'll be good to go for this year. If we don't have a physical on file, which that means probably all incoming seventh graders and a lot of ninth graders, they're going to have a physical. And if you check yes to questions 1 through 6, you're going to have to go get another physical.
All right, so let's talk about, we all like to watch our sports. We all like to be sitting in the stands. With COVID, obviously, you know, we're hearing all kinds of things with professional, college, et cetera. What's high school athletics going to look like?
50% capacity right now. That's the guideline that we've been given, and that's what we're going to follow. So we've got plans in place. You know, the big thing for us is we want to make sure our parents get to see their kids compete. So it's going to be challenging at our middle school gymnasiums that don't hold a whole lot to begin with. And then you talk about that being 50% capacity, and then you talk about three games going on in the same night at a middle school gym. So we're working on plans to accommodate all of our parents, whether it's a middle school activity or a high school activity. So there's going to be information coming out soon from our department and from our coaches, how you can get tickets, how you can get in line to get in the games. We'll communicate that.
Okay, so our athletes are out there right now. They are working hard. You know, they're working on strength and conditioning. As the season begins, how are we going to accomplish social distancing to protect our athletes?
You know, we have been, the vast majority of our kids have been back on our campuses and working out since June the 8th. And I feel like we have had some great protocols in place. They were given to us by the UIL. They were given to us by TEA. We have, you know, done temperature checks every day. They have to take a survey on their phone every day. We keep our groups small. We continue the social distancing. So we've had a really good plan in place all summer, and we're going to continue those plans as we bring all of our kids back on campus. But, you know, just a message for our kids and a message for our parents. You know, if, you know, high school athletics are important, and our kids, whether they're band kids, whether they're drill team, whether they're cheerleaders, whether they're athletes of any sports, they work really, really hard to compete. And the UIL and TEA have done a tremendous job of giving us an opportunity to play. So when it comes to social distancing, when it comes to wearing masks, just a message to our kids would be, when you're not with us, when you're not in athletics and we're making you do those things, be cautious of the decisions you're making outside of the school day when you're in gatherings with your peers. Because if it's really, really important to you to play or even just to attend, you know, just to be a student and come watch, that's going to be important that we all do our part, so to speak, to do our very best to have our athletic seasons.
Well, Coach, do you have anything else you want to tell us about?
No, I think that's it. Just, you know, look for lots of communication coming from our coaches and coming from the athletic department. I feel like we've got a really good plan in place. I will say this, that's the plan in place we have today. It could change tomorrow, but it's the plan we have in place today, and we're going to communicate that out. Contact your coaches, contact the athletic department if you have any questions or need additional information.
Well, thanks, Joel, so much for coming in and answering so many of these questions that our athletes and families of athletes and sports fans in general have. We really appreciate you coming in.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
So NISD athletes, let's do your part out there. Let's wear our masks. Let's social distance. Let's follow all the rules. Take all the precautions that we need to take so that we can get you back on the court, back on the field, and ready to play some athletics this coming year. We'll see you guys later.